Hi, everyone. Welcome back. Last time, we talked about mean moments and bullying behavior. So bullying behavior is when it happens over and over and over again. And at Dare to Care, we talk about it as being a week or longer. That's when we call it bullying behavior. Mean moments are different. Mean moments only happen once or twice, and most of us have experienced that before. Sometimes it's when we have a bad day, or maybe we haven't had a great sleep one night. The important thing is that we apologize and we don't do it again. This big word, discrimination, is a particular kind of bullying behavior that we want to spend a little time learning about. So it's a pretty big word. Let's talk about what that means. Discrimination is when a person or a group of people is treated unfairly compared to others. It could be about their religious beliefs. Did you know that there are over 4,000 religions in the world? It could have to do with their cultural, foods or clothing. Maybe some of your classmates bring some delicious foods to school from their culture, or some of your classmates or even your neighbors wear special clothing to respect and honor their religion. It's not fair to say unkind things about them based on those things. Another form of discrimination is around gender identity, which means how we choose to share or express our gender. It could be about the color of their skin. Sometimes even a disability is a reason that someone is discriminated against. It could be a disability that you can see, like the way they move, perhaps they're in a wheelchair, or it might be something you can't see, like the way they learn or the way their brains work. If you really think about it, none of us likes to be teased or made fun of for any reason at all. So it doesn't make much sense for anyone to say unkind things to someone else simply for being who they are. Do you remember when Lisa talked to you about the kindness meter? We want to work really hard at being up here in the kind part with our words and our actions, or even neutral. Do you remember the expression Lisa talked to you about? Think about it. I think you'll remember it. That's right, you got it. If you don't have anything nice to say, don't say anything at all. Great job. Discrimination is definitely not near the top of our kindness meter. It's when someone is not treated fairly because of who they are, and that's not okay. Here's a little story that will help you better understand what discrimination is all about. The name of the story is Discrimination is a Big Word. I hope you enjoy it.
Discrimination is a big word.
What does that word mean?
Discrimination. I think maybe I know, but why don't we read the story and find out what it means? There once was a town with only one color. They liked only orange and wanted no other.
There were orange flowers in pots, and orange ice cream in freezers. Orange trees, orange kittens, orange foxes, and orange cheese on orange crackers. The people who lived there loved the orange shade. Not purple, not yellow, no, not even in suede. In the center of town was a school. Can you guess? Yes, it was painted bright orange, just like all the rest. Each morning the school bus stopped near every orange house. In hopped a boy in orange pants and a girl wearing an orange blouse. The children loved learning many new things. They loved science and spelling. Oh, they loved all the numbers, both even and odd. And they loved making art that was dazzling. Each school day at exactly 10 minutes past 10, they went out for recess and played games once again. They loved to skip rope and swing in the swings. They hopped in their hopscotches and climbed climby things. They were usually friendly and kind to all. Oh, but once in a while, they were not. Oh, not at all. Sometimes a creaky, crawly, cranky, moody mood would appear, and mean words would be said that caused more than one tear. Skipping breakfast sometimes could make it come by, or tired, grumpy children let it creep in on the sly. One morning, the cranky mood slipped in with a swish like a serpent. It had nothing to do with hungry, tired, or mad. It was only because someone was different. This is what happened. A new student appeared, and to each of them, he looked very weird. He was a strange shape. His color was odd. It made them all wonder if he should be feared. He didn't look like anyone else. No, no, not at all. He was round, 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 and he bounced just like a ball. Oddest of all was the color. Oh my! Certainly not one they saw every day. His color was blue, and they really weren't sure that was okay. They huddled together in groupie groups, all best friends forever and ever. Some giggled, pretending to bounce. Without knowing why, they started to think, oh, he was a loser. I bet he rolls off the bed every night. My grandpa says orange is better than blue. He's weird. His color might rub off on you. One little student, the smallest of all, didn't whisper and giggle. Though she saw he was different, these words made her feel awful. She wasn't big and she wasn't brave. Even her voice was quite small. So she watched with big eyes and said nothing at all.
Okay, wait a minute. Real people aren't blue and orange. They aren't squares and circles, and they don't bounce like balls.
No, they aren't. But real people don't all look the same, do they? And people don't bounce, that's true. But some people don't even walk. They use a wheelchair. Back in the classroom, the teacher said,
Class, this is blue. Make him feel welcome. It's hard to be new. Right after recess, the children learned math. Yes, thought Blue, this I can do. Plus and minus, how many is that? This was the best. He would fit right in too. Blue, please get the markers. Your table will need them. They're right here. They're all in this bin. Happy to help, Blue gently bounced there and missed what was said with such a mean grin. Watch out, don't you know? He'll get blue on you. Two quickly grabbed markers, but the third was too slow. Blue handed it to her with a smile. Hello. The creaky, crawly mood was right there in the classroom. It left a dusty, musty, unhappy smell. Math wasn't fun for Blue that day, and his bounce went away as well. At lunchtime, Blue sat all by himself. He couldn't eat his blue cheese sandwich, and his box of blueberry juice only made his nose itch. For the rest of the day, he was silently blue. Why didn't they like him? He had no clue. She watched till Blue was gone from view. She thought and she thought about, oh, what to do. She knew what she saw. She knew it was wrong. She'd have to do something before very long. What was the creaky, crawly, cranky, moody mood? It wasn't fair, and she knew it was rude. But what could she do? Wasn't she really too small? Could she do anything at all? The new day started out quite well. Blue wasn't too bouncy. He sat quietly after the bell. He practiced the G sounds, G and J. He learned a new thing, which was how to spell ring. The littlest orange student came to class late and walked in the door with a rather large bin. What was in it? Who knew? You couldn't see in. Once again, at exactly 10 minutes past 10, students left for the playground. It was recess again. They ran with a skip to the swings and big toys, while others formed teams to shoot baskets with the boys. Blue stood all alone on the edge of the games. He thought he might join in and learn some of their names. Then the ball came sailing Blue's way through the air. He gave a great bounce and caught it with flair. He bounced hard for the net, and into the hoop both Blue and the ball went. This made the children very angry. They thought he hadn't played fair. They called him a cheater. They called him a freak. To Blue it became a total nightmare. "You're too different. You can't play with us. Get a clue. Go back where you came from." Orange clashes with Blue. A very loud voice rose over the yelling. "Stop! This isn't right. You can't treat someone like this, and I'm telling." She ran straight to the teacher. Finally, she knew what to do. It could not have been clearer. She found her voice, and it wasn't so small. When you do what's right, you can seem pretty tall. The principal and teachers talked to each one. They explained a new word, discrimination. It was a very big word, and it was hard to spell. But they learned what it meant, and they learned it well. It means you can't treat others badly. Call them names. Say things untrue. Not let them play or speak to them crossly, simply because they look different from you. Our school protects everyone, no matter who. Should you see this, or if it happens to you, here's what to do.
Blue!
Tell anyone who works at the school. It's you they'll protect. They'll do their part. For the worth of a person is in their heart.
So I hope you enjoyed that story. It really talked about how discrimination can mean many, many different things. It could be saying hurtful words, or it could be about leaving someone out because they look different than you, or they move differently, or maybe they're even new to your community. No one likes to feel left out or alone. Everyone wants to fit in. So let's make sure in our school, in our community, we want everyone to feel safe and welcome and included. The story also showed that one person can really make a difference. It just takes one person to step up and be kind and let someone else know that they belong. In grade 3, we're going to learn more about a particular kind of bullying behavior called racism. And that's when a person or a group of people is treated unfairly or unkindly simply because of the color of their skin or maybe their cultural background. It is never okay to say or do unkind or hurtful things to somebody else. For now, let's work at being kind and including one another. I want to share a book with you that goes along with a song, and it's got a really special message. It's about how we all deserve to feel like we belong. It's called Don't Laugh at Me, and I hope you love it as much as I do. Thank you.
I'm a little boy with glasses, the one they call a geek. A little girl who never smiles cause I got braces on my teeth. And I know how it feels to cry myself to sleep. I'm that kid on every playground who's always chosen last. I'm the one who's slower than the others in my class. You don't have to be my friend, but is it too much to ask? Don't laugh at me, don't call me names, don't get your pleasure from my pain. In God's eyes, we're all the same. Someday we'll all have perfect wings. Don't laugh at me. I'm the beggar on the corner, you've passed me on the street. I wouldn't be out here begging if I had enough to eat. Don't think I don't notice that our eyes never meet. I was born a little different, I do my dreaming from this chair. I pretend it doesn't hurt me when people point and stare. There's a simple way to show me just how much you care. Don't laugh at me, don't call me names, don't get your pleasure from my pain. In God's eyes, we're all the same. Someday we'll all have perfect wings. Don't laugh at me. I'm fat, I'm thin, I'm short, I'm tall, I'm deaf, I'm blind. Hey, aren't we all? Don't laugh at me, don't call me names, don't get your pleasure from my pain. In God's eyes, we're all the same. Someday we'll all have perfect wings. Don't laugh at me. Don't laugh